Hey, well, I wanted to talk to you today about God's divine provision and what it really means to step into that. And I love sharing with you guys what it means to step into God's divine provision. And actually, a perfect example of this is Psalms chapter 23. And I'm going to read it to you. You guys can go there with me, where it says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He lets me rest in grassy meadows. He leads me to restful waters. He keeps me alive. He guides me in proper paths for the sake of his good name. Even when I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no danger because God is with me. Your rod and your staff, they protect me. You set a table before me right in front of my enemies. You bathe my head in oil. My cup is so full it spills over. Yes, goodness and faithful love will pursue me all the days of my life, and I will live in the Lord's house as long as I live." And so this is actually David speaking, as many of you know. And Psalms chapter 23 is the perfect example of what it means to step inside of God's divine provision. And I love sharing with you guys messages about God's divine provision, and it's because God's divine provision, it's a place. It's a place that you enter into spiritually. It's a place where you lack absolutely nothing. It's a place where simply all you have to do is show up in the environment. All you have to do is show up in the room. All you have to do is show up in the right place at the right time, and everything is handed to you. And by the time that you've shown up in this place, God has already equipped you. God has already raised you up inside. God has already given you the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding to rightly operate in the environment that you're showing up in. God has already equipped you mentally, emotionally, right, and physically to be able to handle the provision that is going to be given to you, to be able to handle the spotlight that is going to be on you, to be able to handle the things that he's going to drop into your lap, because he's already prepared you for this moment in time, right? And this is why it says, "You set a table for me right in front of my enemies." And a lot of people will misquote this in a way where it's saying God will set a table for you in front of your enemies so that you can make people jealous, so that they can be upset that they dismissed you before you stepped into this moment that God has placed you in. But really, the table is being set in front of your enemies so that you can begin to minister to them the heart of God, so that you can begin to show them what it's like to be truly in the provision of God, right? So that they can begin to also themselves step into what it is that God has for them. It's not so that you can provoke jealousy in people, it's so that you can bring them out as well. So the place of God's divine provision is a place where you lack absolutely nothing. It's a place where all you have to do is show up at the right moment and the right time, and everything falls into perfect alignment, God's perfect order for you. And I speak this over you right now. God has begun to show me, and this is why I did this video, that a lot of you are actually about to step into this moment in time right now. So I pray right now over you that nothing shall hinder this moment in time in your life. Nothing shall hinder the provision, the place of provision that God has you on the way to right now. I cancel it right now in the spirit. I speak this over you. God has begun to show me that many of you are about to enter into a place of God's divine provision. And this is a place, like Psalms chapter 23 says, where you will lack nothing, and there will be a table prepared before you in the presence of your enemies. And I'm encouraging you to use this as an opportunity to minister to them the heart of God, and to keep the character that God has cultivated you to be over all of this time of testing that he's brought you through, right? And many of you, if you stepped into this moment of God's divine provision, he's already taken you through a season of testing. So it's important that you remember, right? Remember what the Lord told to the Hebrew Israelites. He said, "Remember how I brought you out of Egypt." He said, "Remember how I brought you through the wilderness. Remember those things that I did for you when I bring you over the Jordan into the promised land. Do not forget the things that I did for you." So remember the season of testing that God brought you through when you step into this season of divine provision, so that you can minister the heart of God to your enemies that are going to be right beside the table that God prepares for you in front of them. And I speak this over you. I request that you bring this to the heart of God. Don't just take my word for it. Take this to the heart of God. Seek the scriptures on this. Go over Psalms chapter 23 and ask God for confirmation that this word is for you.